4.16. And we want to spread it to that, that many leave and do the song all over the hill.
Yeah.
She's a bad man with Jamie. I like to see her right out the service. That's my wife. God is good, amen.
Yes, sir.
Thank you. I want to, if you will, look at a very familiar text. As we share in what seemed to be a very familiar season or holiday. The text is found in the third chapter of the book of John. The Gospel of John. When you found it, we ask that you might rest on your feet. And lead your honor to the reading of John's holy and divine word. This text is so familiar that I really don't even need to tell you, it is the 16th verse. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believes in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. Let me read it again. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believes in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. The Lord have a blessing upon reading this holy and divine word. As I tend to preach on something this morning, are you ready for Christmas? Are you ready for Christmas? Let us pray. Gracious and eternal God, our Father. It is getting to be coming your name. We pray, God, that you might speak to us, that you might speak through us. Allow your word to have its own way in this place this morning. Touch right now. We bind up anything that's not like you, God. Pray, God, your word might once again go forth with authority. But yet, God, it might be received from us now. And all the children of God will say hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
And amen.
And amen.
I want to, if you will, take advantage of a teaching moment. Amen. This very familiar passage of scripture that God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son. I'm afraid that most of us, many of us, if not all of us, have gotten what the young folk call gotten it twisted. As we celebrate what we call this Yuletide season. times this week as I have gone to the bank or to the grocery store or to various places that folk have asked me the question, are you ready for Christmas? And for most part, I say what I've oftentimes heard my daddy say. He would oftentimes say that I'm as ready as I'm going to get. Amen. But what concerns me is that what does one expect? What kind of response does one expect when they ask the question, are you ready for Christmas? For the most part, the person is probably talking about, are you physically ready? Have you gotten all of your lights out, flavorables in the yard? Have you gotten all your decorations put up? They might be talking about financial. Do you have your money set aside so you can buy the appropriate gifts for the appropriate people so that you can celebrate, not the act of giving, because it's not really even the act of giving anymore, it's the act of exchanging. Amen.
Amen.
Most of us give gifts to folk that we think will give gifts to us.
Amen.
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 So, and then we hope that we don't spend too much more on them than they spend on us. And in fact, it would do us better if I gave you $20, you just gave me $20 back. Amen. I mean, it would certainly eliminate the fact that I had to stand in long lines to get you what I thought you wanted that I could, and most that I probably could afford at that time. Amen. Christmas was initially designed as the act of evangelism. Amen. It was so that the church could compete and evangelize and win people to the body of Christ.
Amen.
Amen. But what most of us don't understand is that most of what we recognize now as Christmas really had nothing to do with Christmas. I'm losing some of y'all right now. What if I told you that the Christmas tree has nothing to do with Christmas? What if I told you the wreath had nothing to do with Christmas? Amen. What if I told you that Rudolph and Frosty and none of those guys had anything to do with Christmas? According to the Word of God. What if I told you that what we now celebrate as Christmas is more geared towards pagan influences than Christian influences?
Amen.
Amen.
What if I told you that there was a teacher just last week that got in trouble for telling the children the truth about Christmas? But nobody got in trouble for telling a lie.
Amen.
Amen.
That doesn't make much sense.
It's true.
But that's how Satan gets the glory out of everything he puts his hands on. And then we get caught up in this financial whirlwind that has nothing now to do with evangelism, but now it has to do with commercialization of Christmas. And we feel all of this pressure in order to satisfy other folk, especially our children, in something that in our actuality becomes fraudulent.
Y'all know y'all know.
Move back. Move
back. But I'm trying to help somebody.
Move back.
Keep it coming.
Because
of the situation, for most believers, Christmas is about receiving and not about giving. But the initial origin of Christians came about in John 3:16. For God so loved the world that he what? That he gave. So when somebody asks you the question, are you ready for Christmas? The real thing that you need to check is whether or not you are a giving person, not whether or not you are a receiving person. I mean, there's nobody as a child that was more about Christmas than me. Amen. Because I just knew that Christmas time meant that I was going to get something. Amen. I wasn't so much interested in whether or not I was going to give anything. I was more interested in whether or not I was going to get something or not. For 15 years, my daddy got the same bottle of Old Spice. Amen. And if I could afford it, a pair of cheap socks. Amen. What, are you ready for Christmas? Are you ready to give sacrificially as God has given to you? The Bible said that he so loved the world that he gave, no, not a cattle on a thousand hills, because guess what? That would have cost him nothing. No, not that he gave silver and gold, but the silver and gold would have cost him nothing. But God gave his only begotten Son, Jesus Christ, because that cost him everything. To give this Christmas? How much are you willing to give of yourself? Because now as I look back in retrospect, although my father, and as loving as he was, he gave me things. But you know what I wanted more for my dad? For him to just spend time with me. And to be my friend. And to be somebody that understood me so I wouldn't have to go out into the world and find acceptance for my friend, my other partner that I thought was my friend. If I could do it all over again, if my dad really asked me what I wanted from him, I wouldn't tell him I wanted a G.I. Joe or I wanted a Nintendo or this, that, or that. I would have really told him, Dad, I just want to spend some time with you. Isn't that what we really want? Diamond rings and things are good. But those aren't really the priceless things that makes a difference in relationships. Amen. I need to know that you love me beyond a shadow of a doubt. I need to know that you love me because you're willing to spend time with me. I need to know that you love me because of the way that you talk to me, the way that you understand the things that I'm going through. My wife and I decided a long time ago in our relationship that spending time with each other was the most valuable gift that we could give each other.
Amen.
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 Are you ready for Christmas? As we are gathering together and fellowship with one another, there's people in the family that you don't even speak to anymore. At Christmas time. Amen. places that you want to go because you think somebody else is going to be there. At Christmas time, that folk that you walk past that you want to say a loving word to at Christmas time. So if you really ask you, you really ask the question, are you ready for Christmas? Are you two not ready to forgive one another? Guess what? You're not ready for Christmas. Because your readiness for Christmas is really contingent upon the fact of where you treat one another. And some of us just aren't there yet.
Yeah.
back and give to. Amen. Nothing back. Just to give. There was another family that had somebody broken their house and stolen their gift. Opportunity to do what? To give. Get nothing back. That's a prize and a gift to folk. Not my money. But it's the stipulation. What are you willing to give this Christmas? I'm savage. Sacrificially. How much are you willing to give of yourself? What are you willing to do for somebody? Because that's what it boils down to. God gave to us. Why? Because he saw the condition of mankind. Look around you, and as you look around you, you see the condition of mankind. No pat on the back. No accolades that you can put on your wall. No recognition with your name put up in lights, but just give. The question this morning is this: are you ready for Christmas? No, not because you have wreaths on your door, not because you have a Christmas tree in your living room, no, not because you have inflatables in your front yard, not because you have lights around your window, but are you ready for Christmas? Because you're willing to give a sacrifice of yourself. You're willing to give God the best of who you are. To give. God wants us to give. That's what I'm calling for this morning. I'm calling for a spirit of giving.
Amen. Yes.
As God has given you the breath of life this morning. All that you have belongs to him. And without him, you're nothing. Because he gave to me, I'm willing to give my whole self to him. I give him my praise. I give him. He woke me up this morning and started me on my way. I give God my praise, the breath of my lips. I give him God for all. Just like that gentleman gave to me. And he entrusted me to give. Look around you. There are people who are in dire need.
Hallelujah.
I want you to give. Amen.
Brian, come here, Brian. Come here, Brian. This is Nathaniel Brown. He don't know this. But Nathaniel, he's going to Texas this week, right?
Next week.
And he was just telling me he's going up there to get his license back. Amen?
Amen?
Amen? Amen. And he didn't know when he told me that the Lord had put on my heart that he was going to be one of the recipients of the people that I'm going to give to. Amen? So Brian, come to from St. Stephen's Church and the Rod Acott Foundation, we want to give you $200. Amen?
Give God the glory. Give God the glory. Give God the glory. Give God the glory. Amen.
Amen. He didn't ask for it, but God saw fit for him to have.
Amen.
Amen. Because he is a loving, you know what? I got 4 more gifts I can give away between now and Christmas. Amen. To unexpected people. Because that's all the stimulation. I can't spend it on me. And I can't put it in the bank. Amen. And that's what God did to us. He gave to us something that we could never, ever give back to Him. For the rest of our lives, we will be indebted to God because He so loved us that He gave His only begotten Son that whosoever believeth Him should have eternal life. Amen?
Amen?
What a wonderful gift for God to give to us. Look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, are you ready for Christmas? Give the best of yourself. Let us all stand. Let us all stand. And if there's one who knows not the Lord and the partner of his sins, who's one who has yet to surrender your life to Jesus, if you're here, watch your car right now. Whatever you need, God's already got it.